Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Guess what I'm gonna do today? I'm gonna help you make your PC into a gaming PC. Now I don't mean full or almost as good as a gaming PC. I mean at least half or three fourths. Okay? Still, Fortnite will glitch. I've tried. So the first step, you see this temp and temp 2 over here? So how you go to them is different. You go here and type in percentage temp percentage. Enter. And all of these will come. Now obviously on yours more will come because I remove these files every day. You should too. Even temp 2 is different. You can't go here. You have to right click on start and press run, and here is it's prefetch. Okay, prefetch, and press OK. And now obviously these will be more because these grow faster. And there will always be one irritating file called pfpre5d blah 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 dot mkd whatever. Okay, just skip that. Now see, one more came, so I delete it. And again skip. Okay, refresh twice. After every step, refresh twice. Okay. Now what you do is you go to your this PC shortcut or this PC whatever. Now you go to your C disk. You right click on it and go to properties and press disk cleanup and press OK. Now if you're wondering, delete files. Okay? Don't think it's gonna delete all your data and all of that. It's not going to delete any data of yours. Do not worry. These are all cache and temporary files. Okay? Delete files. On your computer, it will happen slower than mine because I do this daily. Disk cleanup again and press cleanup system files. Now, do not worry. I know what I am doing. Okay? This will take more time because these are all of your system system cache and all of that, so that will be more. See, even if you scroll down, it's two more. Okay, press OK and press delete files. I told you this will take more time, so you'll have to wait patiently. And if it's done, just move your mouse, okay, and press OK. Do not waste time on your Lenovo IdeaPad D disk, okay? I've renamed it, so it'll be Lenovo D disk for you. Do not waste time on that, because even if I go to disk cleanup, it'll show 0 bits. And if I go to cleanup system files, it'll show 0 bits. Okay, so don't. It's really, really a waste of time. So now refresh. Okay, now what you do is you go hold control shift and press escape on your keyboard, and now this process performance app history blah 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 will come. You have to go to startup and you have to do every single app disabled except for the ones you want. You should keep these enabled. This Windows Security Notification icon, program, and program. There might be only two programs for you, but there are three for me. Okay? And I like my f.lux enabled. If you watched my first video, you know what my f.lux is, okay? I like it enabled. Refresh twice. This is like the fourth most thing that will make your computer faster. Now once everything is done, you have to restart your PC, okay? And you can see how fast it is just by restarting your PC. And I'm gonna teach you a desktop shortcut to do that. You hold Alt and press F4 on your higher keyboard, and this shutdown option will come. Press the down button and it will go to restart. Press the up button and it will go to sleep. Sign out, switch user, shutdown, restart. You can find all of these things. Okay? Now, I'm going to do defragment. You have to go here and type D. If this doesn't come, type frag. If it still doesn't come, just type defragment and it will come. This, okay? You have to tap on it. And you have to tap on both your disks for this. Okay? And press optimize all. This will take a lot of time. But now since I do it daily, okay? It doesn't take so much time for me. Refresh. Okay. Now, I'm going to make your computer faster battery-wise. If you don't want to do this, it is fine because it takes up a lot of battery. But at least listen to the next part so that you can get more battery-saving, high-performance thing. So, first we'll do ultimate performance, then we'll do high performance. So you go here to run. I'm gonna put this down in the comment section, okay? I'm gonna put this thing down in the comment section so y'all can just copy it and paste it, okay? I'll copy it. I'll close it. Then you right click on start and press Windows PowerShell admin. Do not press Windows PowerShell. Press admin. And now once this comes, okay, press Control V and this will come. And tap enter. Okay, now it will show here ultimate performance. That's the most important thing. If that doesn't show up here, please contact me. The first video has all of my numbers. So watch the first video's ending. Okay, so now I close this, refresh twice. The step is not done. I still like refreshing though. You either go to Windows Mobility Center and tap on Ultimate Performance, or you could right click and go to power options and press ultimate performance here. Now since I already have it here, I'm just going to delete this plan. Okay? If you don't want ultimate performance, right click Windows Mobility Center, and I either suggest you do balanced or high performance, because once you do power saver, to restart your computer, I swear I've tried, it will take 30 minutes, okay? Even if you do all of these steps, it will still take you 30 minutes. Now it's time to unpack your CPU. Okay? So you go to any search engine and type unpack CPU download. Okay? And press the first one that comes and hit download. Okay, and once it's, and it will show some circle here. Once that circle is done downloading and once it starts beeping, okay, close your Google and go to download. Now since mine is here, I'll tap on that, close the download. Put my unpacked CPU wherever I want. Suppose I want it here. Now I don't want to replace the file destination. Okay, so I'm just gonna close this and close this and refresh my page twice. I go to that and it will be on the list. Right click on this and tap open, the middle one. Oh no, I must have pressed scan with Microsoft Defender. Oh never mind, I'm just scanning it. So I'll press open. Now I suggest you close every single app of yours, okay? Now I press check status. And now I'll just have to wait for a really long time for this to stop and for two CPUs to come on my screen. Okay guys, so it's done checking status or check statusing or whatever it's called. I'm not good at English. So now you just press unpack all. But now since mine are already unpacked before, I don't need to. And anyways, if it shows unpacked for both, still do it, because it might not be unpacked properly. Okay, now I close this, refresh my page twice, and normally after this I need to restart my computer, but you could do that later after all of these things are done. Okay, now what was next? Oh wait, I think that's over. I think it's over.